Hello everyone, welcome to the Ichimoku.co daily futures market review for the trading day ending Thursday, May 28th. Firstly to gold futures, and here we see a very indecisive trading for the second consecutive trading day. This doji candle that's formed has found support at the 1185 region for the third consecutive day, being rejected to the upside from there, with the sellers losing commitment down below that level. The problem here for the buyers is that the buyers have lost commitment around the bottom of the Ichimoku cloud for the second consecutive trading day. And we have this second day with a candle with a small body and a larger shadow on the top and the bottom. And that's why we have indecision in the market. The trend is still technically down, but there is some doubt as to whether that trend will continue down. And if the sellers are strong enough to breach 1185, we certainly could see the market trading down to the 1170 region. But not a lot of hope in that occurring at the moment with the strong rejection from there. By the same token, the potential for the market to trade to the upside is severely limited by the strong resistance at the Ichimoku cloud, extending at the moment down through or up through to the 1194 region. So it's becoming less thick, and there may be an opportunity over the next couple of days for the market to break out to the upside. What we want to see, however, if we are going to see a breakout to the upside, will be a bullish breakout and then some strong bullish follow through, and especially the market trading through the round number 1200. Previously, 3 days ago, we saw a strong bearish breakout to the downside, but we didn't see the strong follow through, and it's essential that we do see that. So a market that's really not showing any clear direction here, even though technically we are trading below the Ichimoku cloud. We have a bearishness in the longer term time frame as well as the medium and fast term time frames. So the opportunity is here for the sellers if they're strong enough, and if they can breach 1185, there is an opportunity to trade to lower levels. Now just looking at the Fibonacci extension technique, and here we see for the second trading day the market testing down to and just through the 100% level, with the market forming a very indecisive candle for the second consecutive day. It does suggest that there is good potential for a change of trend to the upside, so we will be looking for confirmation with the market to make a higher high and a higher low. Next to NYMEX oil, and here we see the market trending to the downside in the current candle that is forming. We've seen formation of a candle that's made a higher high and a higher low, changing the trend to the upside, and some bullishness coming into the market. The buyers testing around the 58.32 level, previous strong support in the recent past and prior to that strong resistance. So it is going to be a very important level moving forward. This comes on the back of a white body candle forming with a large shadow on the bottom, and it's something of a hammer type pattern, and it does require confirmation, and we're seeing that confirmation at the moment. Now if the buyers are strong enough to breach a 58.32 level, we may find some strong resistance at the Tenkan-sen indicator trading at 58.72, and then even possibly at the Kijun-sen trading around the 59.30 level. But a breach to the upside of those two indicators would be in line with the market being bullish in the longer term time frame by trading up above the Ichimoku cloud. At the moment, we're not seeing any support from the ticker span, and what we'd like to see is the ticker span move back up above the price action. And I suggest that if we do see a close up above where the market's trading at the moment, we will see the ticker span confirming upside price action, especially in that longer term time frame. And once again, using the Fibonacci extension tool, and here we saw today the market testing down through the 100% level. The sellers being rejected from there, sellers losing commitment down below that level, the buyers coming into the market, closing with control on this candle that has finished trading, and the body has turned white, and it suggests that there has been a shift in momentum from the sellers back to the buyers, and that's what we've seen here today, the trend change to the upside. Next to wheat futures, and following a strong bearish breakout down below the Ichimoku cloud and each of the Ichimoku indicators, we saw the market testing down to the 488 level of support for today's trading, the second last candle on the chart. We failed to breach there in a bearish manner. We've seen formation of something of a spinning top type candle, a lot of indecision in this market, and price rejection down around the lows of the previous day and suggesting a possibility of a change of trend. We did, however, see the market be rejected from the Kijunsen indicator about the 495 level, and that's why this is an indecisive candle where we have upside price rejection and downside price rejection. Now, we do have the market trading down below each of the Ichimoku indicators, and there is potential for the market to trade lower. So we will be watching this 488 level and the lows here, roughly down around about the 481, 482 level. And if we can breach down through there in a bearish manner, we could easily see wheat futures testing down to the 466.50 level of support. Moving next to corn futures, and very different trading than we've seen with wheat futures, strongly trending down below the Ichimoku cloud for quite some time over the last month or so, trending down below the Tenkan-sen indicator, then rallying to find resistance at the Kijun-sen, selling off quite strongly to retest at the Kijun-sen. So very strong negative bias in this market of corn futures. For today's trading, we've seen formation of a white body candle as opposed to the couple of black bodies from the previous day. So a shift in the short-term dynamics in supply and demand favouring the buyers here and suggesting potential for a change of trend, which we're seeing at the moment in this new candle that is forming. There is potential for support at this previous swing low, resistance at this previous support level at the previous swing low at 355, and potential for support at a previous level at 359 with the Tenkan-sen trading very close to there. So some strong potential resistance up around these areas. As I've mentioned, a very strong negative market supported by the ticker span and suggesting that if the market does find resistance around one of these levels, we then could eventually see the sellers come back into the market and trade to lower levels.